Alright folks, today we're making this awesome looking Wagyu short ribs, so stay tuned. Time to grill! So for this video we only need 5 ingredients. Ingredient number 1. These are German Wagyu short ribs from one of my favorite online butcheries, eatventure.de. Eatventure is also capable to deliver to more European states than you might expect. You should check it out. It's also possible to deliver to Austria and to the Netherlands. So for my Netherlands, for my Dutch viewers, don't hesitate to contact the shop. They also deliver to the Netherlands. So check it out. I will put a link into the video description. You could check it out there. So once you've taken it out of the foil, you see this nice marbling here, and we're gonna cut away a little bit of the fat. I usually cut away the fat that is a little bit soft and only try to keep the fat that has a different consistency, so it's a little bit like get rid of the soft stuff here. Of course these short ribs have a higher fat share than other ribs, but we don't cut away all of it, only part of the top thing. So then you might know this from the pork spare ribs, we're gonna have to get rid of the membrane or the silver skin. So this silver skin is really a little bit stronger due to the fact that this one is dry aged as well, and just take a knife, lift it up a little bit, and then you're able to just take it off. So it's that easy, and it helps the meat penetrate and the rub, and it is easier to eat afterwards. So ingredients number 2, Cumeo pfeffer. What is that? Cumeo pfeffer is a lemon pepper, and these peppercorns are basically imported, produced and sold by my online spice bar shop. One of my favorite, they also sell my own rubs, and this has a slight lemon flavor which really fits perfect to the beef for me. And once you're ready with 1 to 1.5 tablespoon of these peppercorns, you have to add 2 more spoons approximately of molten salt flakes. So these are salt flakes, we only break up the salt flakes as well. And then we're just gonna give it a mix, so it ends up in a nice Texas Dalmatian rub with a slight lemon flavor. So that's the goal for today, and this is also the right amount for these 2.6 kilo Wagyu short rib. So there you go, interesting color, a little bit yellow, nice consistency. Now we are coming to ingredient number 3. So this is extra virgin olive oil. It adds additional flavor, and of course it helps the rub to stay on the short ribs. So once you're ready, all sides are oiled up, just simply add the rub. Make sure to cover it everywhere. Of course, I will put a list of all the ingredients into the video description as always, so you can check out the amounts, and I will put a link in there so you can check out how to get the ingredients if you want to. But I will also put links in there to my fan pages. You definitely have to check out my Instagram page and my Facebook page. It would be really cool if you could join us there. You will get some additional information, some photos, behind the scenes footage, and a lot of things more. So once you're ready rubbing this one from all the sides, this is how it looks like. And then we are almost ready to throw this on the grill. So in the meantime, I have prepared my Broil King Keck Kamado cooker for indirect heat, 110 degrees Celsius, approximately 220 degrees Fahrenheit. We're gonna smoke this one in total 11 hours. Yes, 11 hours. But I will show you some shots from in between. So the next one will be up after approximately 4 to 6 hours. I guess it was 5 hours or so. You now start to see how the meat goes backwards. You see more part of the bones. And then I turn it a little bit around so it's a nicer shot for the camera. And this is how it looks like after approximately 8 hours. So we started early in the morning here today. And after 8 or 8.5 hours, we're gonna add some sauce. That's ingredient number 5. I used the steak and beer sauce. You can use barbecue sauce if you like, but I decided to take something different today. So I decided to take a steak sauce. Feel free to use anything you like. You can also left out the sauce. For me, it gives a nice crust and additional flavor here. Not too much for the Wagyu meat. That's how I like it. And exactly this is how it looks like after 11 hours. So after 11 hours, you can still see how juicy it is. It's still dripping. And now you can remove the bones easily. It's the same like you have started with pulled pork. Also, you know, you can now remove the bones easily if the meat is not too hot. So just take out the bones. And we're ready to cut into this and see how we did and how it looks like in the inside. But you can already see how juicy and tender this one is. So I take my new Porsche knife. We're gonna cut into. And boy, does this look good or what? So this is so juicy. We're gonna cut away a little bit of the fat. We're gonna cut this into cubes and then we see how we did. So I'm gonna give this a shot right now. It's really delicious, nice crust, a little bit of lemon flavor. Really juicy, nice meat, really cool. In the meantime, I'd like to thank you for watching. Please hit that like button, subscribe or comment. We're seeing us again in 2 or 3 days. Please check out the links in the video description. Share it with your family and friends. Thanks a lot. I'm out. See you.